All right, and hello everyone. It is me, Jay Burns, and in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you all how to make this giant bow charm here. And this charm is called the Mega Super Bow. I don't know why I didn't name it the Super Mega Bow, but whatever. It's just this giant bow charm here. And I'll be showing you how to make it in this tutorial with an Alpha Loom. So you will need an Alpha Loom to make this design. Then you will also need your usual looming tools, your usual hooks, so your alpha comb and your regular hook, or you can just use a regular hook. And you will not need a template for this tutorial here, because I'll be showing you the entire design, showing you how to make it from start to finish. So I will be making an entire bow in this tutorial, so that's why this tutorial is really long. And it could have been longer because I could have used a template. But if you want to get a template to follow along, even though I won't be showing any templates in this tutorial, then I will have a link to a website where you can go and download and print one out. And I'll also have a link to this channel's Instagram, where I'll have the template, a picture of the template posted on there if you want to check that out. So anyway, you will need just one clip to make the design, and this is while you're making the design. This isn't to close the design off. So this is just to help you when you're making it. So you will need one clip. Then you will need rubber bands, and there are just four groups, usually. But no, there's four groups. I was thinking about colors. But anyway, there are four groups of bands you'll need. You'll need one group of bands for the border of the bow here. You'll need another color for the outside parts of the bow, so these two parts here that are pink and Caribbean green bands. Then you'll need another color for the middle of the bow, which are these gold bands here. And then, of course, you'll need another group of bands for the connector bands, which hold the entire thing together, and that's why you don't have a bunch of little single chains and stuff. So yeah. Down in the description, I'll have the number of each type of band you'll need. Just pretty much listed down there. And also, just use the pause button to get the supplies you'll need. And also, I almost forgot to say this, but this tutorial will be a more advanced tutorial. So if you haven't made anything with your Alpha Loom yet, or you're kind of new to using the Alpha Loom, then I would not recommend watching this tutorial yet. But if you want to give it a try, I'm just letting you know that it is a pretty advanced tutorial. You will need to know a few things about the Alpha Loom, like pretty much the basic looming stuff. And yeah, use the pause button to get the supplies you'll need, and I'm going to go ahead and we're going to get started. So, to begin making this design, you're going to need 7 border bands, and we're going to be starting with pretty much this part right here. You're going to need 7 border bands, and you'll also want to have your regular hook off to the side there. And what we're going to do is we're going to make a little single chain with these 7 border bands. So, you can either do this here on the left side or the right side, but make sure that the rainbow loom words on your Alpha Loom are facing towards you. This is also the same side as where this hole is. So, you'll just make a single chain going down either the left side of your Alpha Loom or the right side, doesn't matter. Just place a simple little single chain coming down towards you, so far and then closer, like so. And then, with your 7th border band, you're going to make it a triple cap band on whichever side you place your single chain on that pin closest to you. And usually in Alpha Loom tutorials, I call that the row 7 pin. So it goes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1 is up here and 7's down here. Alright, but anyway, we're going to make this band here a triple cap band. and, well, I'll go ahead and explain how you do that. You put the band here on that pin, twist it once, and you get this shape that you create, put that onto that pin as well. Then you get these two little layers, you grab another, or you grab one of those two layers there, twist it, and put that on the same pin. And now you got a triple cap band. Now you're going to want to get your regular hook, and we're going to go ahead and loom this single chain. And when you do, just be a little bit careful because everything is a little bit closer together here on the Alpha Loom. The pins are a little bit closer together. So, yeah, just go ahead and loom a single chain. And you can push everything down. And now we're going to start making the bow part of the bow. So we're not on this border anymore. So now what we're going to do is we're going to get some of our bow bands. And the bow bands are pretty much all these bands here that are on the outside. So the outside parts of the bow. I'm going to be calling those the bow bands in this tutorial. And then when we get to the middle, I'll call them something else. We'll get to that. So you're going to get some of your bow bands, and also a border band. And, well, first we're going to place this border band going across our Alpha Loom, just normally, placing it normally, down here where, well, these two pins that are closest to us. So it should be also over the pin that has the triple cap band on it. Then, the remaining six rows of pins, we're going to be placing our bow bands on them. Just placing them normally on our loom. Also, down in the description, I had listed the number of bands for the bow bands in two different amounts. I did one for if you're going to do just single bands, and another amount for if you're going to be doing double bands, which means you're taking two bands and using them as one band. And in this tutorial, I am using two bands as one, but whatever you wanted to use, then that's the number of bands you got, and that's what you're doing right now. So if you wanted to just use one band, so just single bands for the bow bands, then you would just place one going across the pins. Right. Anyway, now you should have something like this here on your Alpha Loom, and we're going to go ahead and loom now. I would recommend using your regular hook for this, because you have this triple cap band here, and it usually causes some problems when you're looming with your alpha comb. So you'll just take your hook and pull over that triple cap band, and then you'll just loom over the single chain onto these bands above. Push everything down. And now what we're going to do is we're going to do pretty much the same thing again, but this time we're going to add connector bands to what we put on our loom. So we're actually going to be placing two connector bands at a time because we need to connect both parts of this big giant bow together. And one connector band isn't going to stretch far enough, so we're going to be using two. We're going to be placing two, and yeah, I'm going to show you how exactly we're going to do this. So we're going to take one, and we're going to just place it here on this pin, or one of these two pins, furthest away from us, and also make sure that every single time you go to place bands on your loom, the rainbow loom words on the Alpha Loom are facing towards you, or this little hole here. So always make sure that this stuff here is the closest thing to you when you place bands. Alright, anyway, you place the connector band up there, one of them, then you take the second one and you just place it like you would normally when you're making a normal Alpha Loom design. Just like that. And I would recommend putting them on the same side. but whatever you want to do. Anyway, after you've done that, now we're going to place the same bands we did before. We're going to get one border band and then however many bow bands you're using to fill up the remaining six spots. So, first you're going to take your border band and place it over the same two pins that you did the first one, which is right here. And then all the remaining places, the remaining six rows of pins, we're going to place our bow bands. All right. And then once you've done that, you should have something like this. And now you can get your alpha comb out, if you're using that. And first we're going to loom the connector bands. So to loom the connector bands just like normal, except for this one connector band we have here that we just set on the pin, we'll just pull that up and over like so. And it's a little bit easier to do it with just your fingers, so yeah. Anyway, then we'll go ahead and just loom the bands like normal. And I accidentally grabbed another band, so I need to find it. There we go. And then once you've loomed all the bands, the bottom bands there, you can push everything down. And now we're going to do this one more time. So we're going to get two connector bands first. We're going to put one just sitting there on one pin, and then the other, just place it regularly. And then we're going to place all the exact same bands again in the same places. So the border band is down here first, and then the remaining six spots are all the bow bands. Then we're going to go ahead and loom the bands normally again. Don't forget to get that second connector band. And now what we're going to do is something a little bit different now. So we're not going to go through and place everything the same way again. What we're going to do is we're going to take, so we're still going to get our connector bands. Okay, so we're still going to have our connector bands, but we're also going to need to get our regular hooks out. So before we go to place our connector bands, what we're going to do is we're going to do something with this border band and this bow band right next to it. So first we're going to use our regular hook to get this, to grab one side of this bow band here. Carefully take it off that pin it's on and bring it down to this border band's pin. Then we'll do the same thing for the other side, like that, and then we'll move both of the bands back to where the bow band was before. So we'll grab all of those bands on that pin now and move them back to where the bow band was. So now you should have this border band underneath this bow band, on this pin here. And then you'll do the same thing for the other side. Oops, just dropped a bow band. Let me grab that. There we go. And now everything will be pretty much the same, except instead of placing a bow band on these two pins here, we're going to place a border band here. So I'll show you. First, we're going to go ahead and place our connector bands normally, but we're going to go ahead and exclude these two pins that are closest to you. So you'll just place the connector band like that, and the other ones are just, you know, normal right there. Then, instead of placing our border band down here, we're going to put it right on these two pins now. Then, we'll get our bow bands to fill in the remaining five spots now. So whether you're doing double bands or just single bands, you just go ahead and place them normal. And then, looming will be the same as well. We'll get our alpha comb or our hook, and we'll loom the connector bands first. And then the only difference will be is that there's just this additional border band down here. And there won't be any pins on these two pins here. Any bands. So, just be a little bit careful when you're looming. And then you could push everything down like normal. And then we've gone through that row there. Right. Now we're going to do pretty much the same thing again, but it's going to be even bigger, I guess I should say. So instead of taking the bow band that's right next to this border band, or wait, no, we're going to go ahead and do that. So we're going to go ahead and do the same thing again with our regular hook. We're going to take this bow band that's closest to this border band, bring it over to that border band's pin, do it on both sides. Then we're going to go ahead and move these bands up to where the original bow band was, just like we did before. Dropped one of the bow bands again. There we go. And then we're going to do the same thing one more time. So we're going to take these bow bands that are next to this pin with the border band on it. So now these bow bands here, we're going to bring it down to this same pin with this other bow band and this border band. And you'll do it on both sides. So now this time you should have twice as many bow bands on the same pin as this border band here. And we're going to go ahead and actually just leave the bow band and the border band here. Because if you used double bands, so you used two instead of one, there's probably a lot of, well, there's five bands on the pin, and my hook isn't quite big enough to grab all of them. But if you only used single bands for your bow bands, then you can move all these bands here to this pin where the second bow band was originally. But we're just going to go ahead and leave this there so we don't mess anything up. So So now, pretty much the same thing as before. You still get your connector band, or your two connector bands. And let me just check something real quick. I don't want to mess something up. Yeah, so we still get two connector bands. That's the next row. And everything is just like normal. So you place your connector bands, and then you place the one border band here, above where this other border band is, instead of on these two pins. Or these two pins. And then you're going to get the bow bands you need to fill in the remaining three spots now. Now, if you didn't move the bow band and the border band from the two pins we had them on, because there were just too many bands to move, then make sure you do not place any bands on these two pins, because there's nothing on them except for that connector band, so. So if you're doing what I'm doing, you should have something like this here on your loom. And nothing is on these two pins except for that connector band. So anyway, now we're going to go ahead and get our alpha combs and we're going to loom like normal. But this one pin, where there's a lot of bands, you might want to use your regular hook to loom these bands here. So I'll go ahead and loom them last. Go ahead and use my regular hook and do them. Make sure you get both sides, and then you can push everything down. And then you'll also want to get this border band. If you didn't move it before, you're going to go ahead and move it closer to the rest of the bands on your loom. That's only if you didn't move the bands before. Alright, now what we're going to do is, now we're just going to get one connector band now. So we're just going to use one connector band, because the other half of the bow, when we go to make it, there's only going to be three rows of pins there, and, or three rows of pins with bands on them. So the connector band will only be stretching across across seven rows, like a normal Alpha Loom connector band. So we're just going to get one connector band and place it normally. And we're going to get one border band, place it over the two pins that has the border band underneath of it, or on it already. And then we just need the border, oh my gosh, and then we're just going to need the bow bands to fill in these remaining three rows of pins. Alright. Then, we're just going to go ahead and loom the bands like normal. Connector band first. Hold on, let me check something. Ah! Alright, so I just realized something. Need to unloom this spot here. Yeah, we do. Well, we just need to unloom the connector band and this band here, this bow band, and this border band. Because I just remembered something, and upon looking at the template, it's just a small little mistake here. Okay. So anyway. Just go ahead and take off that bow band and that border band. And we need to do pretty much the same thing we've been doing. I'll also take this connector band and pull it out of there, like, pull it out of there. Now it's just loose like that. Alright, so anyway, we need to do pretty much the same thing we've been doing. We need to take the bow band here that's right next to the border band, put it over that border band on both sides, and then bring both that bow band and that border band to the original place where the bow band was. You need to make sure you grab it all at one time. And now this should all be fixed, and what we can do now is grab this loose connector band here, just pull it onto that pin like that, and then we just need one border band, place that over that, and then take this connector band, pull it over, and loom these bottom bands up and over. Alright, so there we go. Just a little thing we had to fix there. Alright, so anyway, now what we're going to do is we're going to get one connector band again, and it's only stretching across these three pins. And now what we're going to do is we're just going to place border bands. So we're just going to place three border bands going across the loom. Then we're going to go ahead and just loom the bands. And now we're going to start adding our middle band, so all the bands that'll be in the middle of the design. And to do the first little row here, we're just going to need two of the middle bands. So these gold bands here in the example. That's what we're adding. We're just going to need two of them and a border band, of course. So first we're going to get our connector band, place it going across these pins here. Then our border band is going to go across these two pins that our bow is still being made on, and these two pins that are closest to us. Just remember the rainbow loom words here. And then you take the other two bands, the two middle bands, and you fill in these two little spots here. Then we go ahead and loom. And what we're going to do is we're going to do this exact same thing two more times. So it's just like making a regular Alpha Loom bracelet, except there's just three little rows of bands here, and yeah, so you're just going to do this exact same thing two more times. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. You place the bands in the exact same places you had put them before. So here is one. I have my loom like this, and here is two. So I'm going ahead and just looming for the second time, and there we go. All right, now we're going to do almost the same thing again, except we're going to have three border bands instead of one border band and two middle bands. So we'll get three border bands, and we're still going to get our connector band, of course. We'll place that connector band first. And then we'll just place our three border bands going across the loom, like just like this. And then we'll loom everything like normal. And now we're going to do something a little bit different. So now we're going to start working on the other side of the bow. And the other side of the bow has to get bigger. Alright, So what we're going to do is we're going to take our regular hook. Yep, we're going to take our regular hook and we're going to just pull it. Yeah, we're going to take our regular hook. We're going to take this border band that is closest to us. We're going to grab it and we're not going to pull it off of the pin completely. We're not going to pull it off this pin it's on at all. We're just going to stretch the band out to the pin below it. So you got something like this here. And I'll show you a little bit more closely with the other side. So you just grab this band and not pulling it off the pin, but just bringing it over to the other pin as well. So one pin down. So now this band is stretched out like this here. Now, we're going to place a connector band, just one, and we're going to start getting our bow bands again, and one border band, and we're going to place our one border band here on these two pins that are closest to us, like always. And then the bow bands, we'll place them normally, just filling in the remaining three spots here. Okay, so I definitely got too many bands, so there we go. Then, looming is still normal, it's just we have this one band down here that's stretched across four different pins. And there you go. So anyway, now we've gotten through that row there. Now what we're going to do is we're moving back into the rows of the design where we're going to be using two connector bands. But before we do that, we're going to do something similar to what we had done before with the border band. Instead of taking the border band and extending it out to another pin, we're going to take this border band with our hook, at least one side of it, and we're going to bring it all the way down here so that it's on this pin that is the second closest to us right now. And we'll do the same thing with the other side. And now we're going to go ahead and use the two connector bands. So now we're going to do pretty much the same thing we've been doing for our design. Or for the bow, we're going to take one connector band, just set it right there, up there on that pin, and then place the other connector band normally going across the alpha loom. And make sure you get it all the way down here where this border band is as well. And we're going to place the bands we need. So we're first going to place this border band on these two pins here, and then on the remaining five spaces, the remaining five rows here, we're going to place bow bands. So even on these two rows of pins where there aren't any other bands, we're still going to put bow bands on those pins. Then we're going to go ahead and loom once again, and it's just going to be like normal. We'll go ahead and get our connector bands, we'll loom them both up and over, and then we'll go to loom the bottom rubber bands. There just simply won't be any bottom rubber bands underneath these two bands here on these two rows. Get both sides, and yeah, now we're going to get our regular hook again, and we're going to bring this border band out one more time so that it's on these two pins that are closest to us. So we'll go ahead and extend the band out here, And then we're still going to get two connector bands. One's going to be placed up here, and the other's going to be placed regularly, going across all 7 rows. And then we're going to go ahead and place the same bands we did here in the beginning. We're going to get one border band, place it going across these two pins closest to us, and then the remaining 6 rows of pins here, we'll place our bow bands. Alright, there we go. So then we're going to loom again. And when we go to loom the bottom rubber bands, there just won't be any bottom rubber bands underneath this bow band here on these two pins. So, just be aware of that. Alright, there we go. Now, we're going to just place our bands the same way we did in the beginning. We're going to be placing the 6 rows of pins here with our bow bands, and then this row here, these two pins, will have the border band. And we'll just repeat pretty much what we did here at the very beginning of the bow 3 more times. Yeah, 3 more times. So we'll get 2 connector bands. One will be sitting up here, the other one will be stretched like a normal connector band. Then the border band is down here, and all the bow bands are in the remaining 6 spots here. Then we go ahead and loom. And now there should be bottom rubber bands for all 7 rows. And once you finish looming, you'll go ahead and do the same thing 2 more times. We're going to do it 2 more times, and yeah, and then I'll show you how you finish off this half of the bow. Ooh, almost forgot my 2nd connector band. So there's one. And here is two. Alright. So, now what we're going to do, once you've finished that, is now we're going to close off this side of the bow so we can make the other half of the bow, because as you can see, pretty much the bottom half is missing, so we need to make that. And yeah, so we're going to need our regular hook right now. And we're going to take all of the bands that are here on our loom, and we're going to kind of bring them from one side of the loom so that they're all on one side. So here, I'll show you. So you take your hook, you grab one side of this border band here, take it off that pin, and bring it directly over to the other side, like so. Then you do the same thing with this bow band here. You grab the same side as you did with the border band. So you grab the same side, pull it off the pin, bring it over to the other side, directly across, like that. And you'll do this for all of the bands. So it's just like finishing off a regular Alpha Loom bracelet. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take border bands, and you'll also want to have that clip I told you to get out at the beginning. You want to have that nearby as well. And put that over there. And what we're going to do is we're going to take these border bands and we're going to use our hook to make a single chain going through all these bands here on one side of the Alpha Loom. So we're going to start down here. We're going to take our hook and start down here where this border band is. This one that's on our loom. We're going to stick our hook going all the way through that band. Get another border band. Pull it up through. Make sure you hold on to the other end. Then you'll take your hook and go into the next band, which is a bow band, and then put the other end of this border band on your hook. Then you'll do the same thing again. You'll get a border band. You'll put on your hook like so. Pull your hook going back up through all these bands here. And it might be a little bit difficult, or it's going to be more difficult if you have more bands for the bow bands, but you're going to take your hook, you're going to pull it through all those bands there, then take your hook, put it going down through all the next bands on the next pin, and then put the other end of this new band on your hook as well. And I'll go ahead and show and explain what you're going to do one more time, and then you can just do the remaining bands and pins. So you take your next border band, put on your hook, pull the hook going all the way up through all these other bands here. Then, once you've gotten it through, you'll take your hook and put it going down through the next band in the next pin, and then put the other end of this new band onto your hook. And, well, you'll just get a new border band and do the same thing again until you get to this last pin here on the other side of the Alpha Loom. Or the other end of the Alpha Loom. So, I'm going to go ahead and continue. You can as well. And then I'll explain what you need to do once you get to that last pin. Alright, so once you get to this last pin here, you're going to go ahead and take, well, you want your clip nearby, so you want to have your clip, you're going to take one more border band, put it on your hook, pull it up through all those bands, then go ahead and put the other end of the border band onto your hook, get your clip, and attach it to this band that's here on your hook right now. So both of those little loops there. Like that. Then you can take your hook out and you can pull all of these bands that are on your loom off. And I like to use my hook to do this. You can just pull it off with your fingers if you want. And now you have finished this top half of your bow. So now we're going to make the other half. And yeah. So same thing, same little rules apply. You still need to make sure that the rainbow loom words are always facing towards you when you go to place bands. And yeah. So we're going to start the bottom, or the other half of the bow, the same exact way. But this time we're just going to get... We're going to get 6 border bands, goodness. So anyway, we're going to be placing them, going all the way down our alpha loom. So either side, doesn't really matter. Just like we did before, we're going to place a single chain of bands going down, coming closer to you. And then for our cap band for this little single chain we made, we're going to get our bow, the part we've already made. We're going to find the side of the bow that doesn't have a clip on it. So there's this side that does have the clip, and then there's this side that doesn't, so we're going to get that side there. And we're going to put it here. So we're going to get this band here at the end of that chain on the border. So we have the triple cap band, and then we have that band here. We're going to take that band, we're going to put it on this pin closest to us. And then we're going to loom this little single chain just like we did the first time. We'll just pull back this band, grab this bottom band, loom it forwards. And just go ahead and loom this little chain here. And push everything down. And now what we're going to do is we can actually go ahead and take... we can go ahead and take this little chain part here off. But it keeps things out of the way if you leave it on, so... Yeah, I'm just letting you know that this one right here is not necessary for the design right now. So anyway, we're going to do pretty much the same thing we've done with the other half of the bow. We're going to get one border band, and then however many bow bands we need to fill in, or we need to place for 5 rows. So either 5 or 10 bow bands. So when we place our border band, we're going to place it going across these two pins furthest away from us instead of these two pins closest to us. Then we're going to get however many bow bands we need to fill in 5 spaces here on our loom. So we're just going to be placing 5 bow bands. Or 10 if you're using double. So you'll have something like this. And then the only thing that's on these two pins at all is this little single chain band from the first single chain we made. Now, we're going to go ahead and either get our alpha comb or our regular hook. I like to use the regular hook for the single chains, and we're just going to loom the single chain onto the bands that we have placed above it. And this is also when you can take this other single chain band here that we didn't place anything above. We can go ahead and take that off as well. Then we can push all those bands down, and now we're going to get right into making the other half of the bow. So, Now, we're not going to be adding any more connector bands, because all the connector bands we need are already a part of the first half of a bow. So we're going to take this first connector band that is closest to our loom here. So we're going to take this one, and we're going to stretch it across our loom, like a normal Alpha Loom band. Nothing extra we need to add. And we're going to take a border band, place it across our loom on these two pins furthest away from us. And then we'll get the bow bands we need to fill in 5 rows of pins on our Alpha Loom. And we'll go ahead and place them. And also, by the way, we are not going to be placing any bands at all on these two pins that are closest to us right now. So these two pins here that are closest to us, the only bands that will ever be on these two pins for this half of the bow will be the connector band. Alright, so anyway, once you've placed what you needed, I'm going to go ahead and loom just like a normal Alpha Loom bracelet or Alpha Loom design. And then we're going to go ahead and do this one more time. Yep, we'll go ahead and do this one more time. So we're going to get this connector band, this very next one now, stretch it across these pins, then place your border band here on the top, and then place the band you need to fill in 5 spaces we'll be using for bow bands. There you go. Then we're going to go ahead and loom. Loom just like normal. And then, just like we did when we had started on this side of the bow, so this first half down here, we're going to get our regular hook, and we're going to do the same thing we did with our border and bow bands when we were making the bow smaller here for this half of the bow. So we're going to take this bow band here that's closest to our border band, and we're going to use our hook to move it over to the pins where the border band is now. Like that. And we'll then take those bands and move them both at the same time to this pin where the bow band was originally. Then, we'll get this next connector band here. We're not adding any more. We'll get this next connector band here on this half of the bow. Stretch it across. And we'll just need to stretch it across one less pin. So not these two pins here. And then, when we get our border band, we'll place it going across these two pins that are almost at the top. They're just on right here instead, and then we'll get the bow bands we need to place them going across 4 rows of a loom here. And there we go. Then we're going to go ahead, and looming will be just the same, it's just we're going to have a few extra bands here. So we'll go ahead and loom like normal. Alright, and then we're going to move the border and bow bands around again, and this time we're going to go ahead and do the same thing. We're going to get this bow band that's closest to this border band, bring it over to that border band's pins, then take them both at the same time and move them over to where the bow band was. Then, we're going to take this next bow band that's next to these other bands here, and we're going to move it onto that pin as well with them. And just like before, if you feel that there's just too many bands there to move over to this pin where these bow bands were before, then just leave those bands there, and we'll move whatever's there later. River gets there later. Or you can just go ahead and take these bands with your hook and just move them over to this pin. But I'm just going to leave mine. And now what we're going to do is we're going to get the next connector band here. We'll stretch it across these pins. And then we'll take our border band and we'll place it going across these two pins here, where there is another border band, but it's just all the way down there at the bottom. And then we'll place the bow bands we need for just two rows of the loom. So not three or four, just two. Because right here, we're not placing any bands at all. If you're doing what I'm doing and you're not moving all these bands yet, make sure you do not place any bands here on this row. Alright. Anyway, looming will be pretty much the same. It's just up here. There's going to be a lot more bands. And I would recommend using a regular hook to loom that. So, that's what I'm going to do. And then you can go ahead and move this border band so that it's right next to all the other bands there, if you didn't move the other bands before. And then we're going to do that little bow band and border band thing again one more time. Take this bow band right next to this border band and move it so that it's on top of the border band, both sides. And then we'll take both the border band and this bow band that we had moved, take them both and bring them over here to where this bow band was before. Now the border band should be here on the bottom, and we'll do the same thing on the other side. And now, Alright, and now, we're going to get this connector band, and it's not going to be sticking out as much if you used double bands for your bow bands, but it might be sticking out a little bit more if you're using just one single band for the bow bands. But you need to find that next connector band in the design And you might need to use your hook to grab it. You need to go in there, grab that connector band, and go ahead and stretch across the pins. And then we're going to get one border band and one bow band, or two if you're using double bands. And we're going to go ahead and place this border band going across this pin, or this row here, that's furthest away from us, that we're still making the design on. And then we'll go ahead and take this bow band and place it across the other two pins there. Then, honestly, you can just take your regular hook and just loom everything like normal. There's just a few extra bands on two of the pins. Now, once you've done that, you're going to find the next connector band, and it is right here. And you'll go ahead and just place it, stretch across those two pins there. Try to pull this bow through a little bit. There we go. A bit easier now. So we'll place that connector band there. And now we're just going to get two border bands this time, and we're going to place them over those two spots. Then loom all the bands like normal. And now we're on the part for all of those middle bands. So now we're going to get one middle band and one border band. We're going to place the border band on the row of pins that's furthest away from us, and also we're still making the design on. Oh, wait, we gotta get the connector band first. Almost forgot. So make sure you get that connector band. Okay. Right, and then you'll place your border band, and the middle band will be on those two pins that are closer to you, and you're still making the design on it. So there's no bands here, so I'm not going to place the middle band there. It's going to be right here. Alright. So anyway, then once again, we'll loom the bands like normal, and we'll go ahead and we'll do this two more times. So we'll place the border band and the middle band in those same two spots two more times. So get this next connector band, then border band, and middle band, and then loom. So there's one. And here is two. Alright. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get the next connector band again. Place it across those pins there. And make sure you're getting the right one. Okay. And now we're just going to place two border bands. Then loom like normal. And now, just like we did when we were making the bow bigger on the other half of the bow, we're going to take this border band here. But this time it's going to be furthest away from us, so the furthest away border band from us, not this one right here, it's closer. We're going to take that one, and we're going to use our hook to pull the band out to this next pin here. So we'll stretch it out like that. So I'll show you a little bit better with this other side. And so now you'll have something like this here. Now we'll get our next connector band. Stretch across. Then we'll take a border band and we'll stretch it and we'll stretch it across this row of pins here. That's furthest away from us, and we're still making the design on it. And then we'll fill in the remaining spots. There are other two spots there. With bow bands. And I'm still going to use my regular hook to loom. Go ahead and loom those bands. And then again, like before, when we were making this side of the bow bigger, so we were making the bow, making it big again, we're going to take this border band here, and we're going to bring it all the way up our loom so that it's on these two pins that are almost at the very top of that loom here. So there should be two pins in between the border band and these other bow bands. We'll find the next connector band. We'll stretch it across our loom. Use my hook. And then we're going to place our border band over the row of pins where there's another border band, and then we'll fill in all these places here in between, so even these two rows of pins, with bow bands. So we're placing enough bow bands to fill in four rows of the loom. It's basically like this here. Then, we're going to loom just like normal, except there's just not going to be any bottom rubber bands for these two rows right here. Push the bands down. Alright, sorry about that, had to grab some extra border bands, but anyway. Then, just like before, we'll get our regular hook, and now we'll take this border band and we'll pull it up so that it is now on these two pins furthest away from us. And now we'll get our next connector band. We'll need to go in there and find it. Here it is. Stretch it across, and we'll place our next border band going across these two pins here where this other border band is, and then we're going to be placing all the bow bands we need to fill in five spots on our loom. Then we'll go ahead and loom all of these bands here. Oh. And looming will just be the same, except for on these two pins, there just won't be any bottom bands. Alright, and so once you've loomed that there, now we're just going to pretty much do the same thing. Well, not the same thing. We're going to go through and place all the exact same bands and loom like normal three more times for the remaining three connector bands we have here, because we only have three connector bands left. So I'll go ahead and explain a little thing here, because we're almost finished our bow here. Let's think for a second. Okay, so anyway. you go ahead and you find your next connector band. Stretch it across here. Then, your border band is going on these two pins that are furthest away from you. And then, you just need to place the bow bands to fill in the rows fill in the spots for 6 rows. Or 5. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's just 5, not 6. And then, once you've placed all that, you can go ahead and loom just like normal. Connector band first, and all the bottom bands. And well, once you've done that, you're now going to do this exact same thing 2 more times, and then I'm going to show you how you completely close off your bow. Alright, and well, here's the second time that I had to go through it. So I'm finishing up here. And yep. All I have to do is push down the bands. And now, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get started on closing this bow off. So you don't need your alpha comb anymore if you're using it. And you might want to take this band here, this border band that has the clip on it, you might want to put that on one of these pins here. And what I like to do is get the bow in, so like this half of the bow that's already made through, and then get this border band onto a pin. I'm going to put it over here. So then you got something like this. Alright, so anyway, you're going to want to get your regular hook now. And just like we did last time, we're going to bring all the bands to one side of the alpha loom. And if you do what I did, you took this border band that had a clip on it, and you put it on a pin. I would recommend taking all the bands and bringing them over to the same side as where that border band is. So you would grab one side of this bow band here, bring it over directly across to the other side, then same thing with the next one, and just do that for all of these bands here. Alright, and once everything's all on one side, now we're going to begin to close off the design. So we're going to go ahead and get the remaining border bands we have, and what we're going to do is we're going to take our hook, we're going to put it going through this border band here that has the clip on it, take that off that pin, and you can go ahead and take the clip off, but I think it's easier to do it when it's on the loom, so I'm going to go ahead and put it back. Alright, there we go. So you can take the clip off, and once it's off, you won't need it anymore. We're going to take this band here that the clip was on. Take one of those loops off, the one closest to your hook. So I'll show you again. You might not saw that. So you have these two little loops for this one band here on your hook. You're just going to take this one that's closest to the hook part of your hook off. But make sure you hold on to it. Right, and then the other end that's still on your hook, you'll keep it on your hook. You'll take your hook, stick it going down through these next bands here, on this next pin, all the way through, and then put this end of the band that you had taken off before, go ahead and put it back on. Now we're going to go ahead and get our remaining border bands, and we're going to add them the exact same way we did when we were making the first half of our bow. So I'll go ahead and show and explain one more time, just in case if you forgot. But what we do is we'll take a border band, we put it on our hook just like so, pull our hook going all the way up through all these other bands, just like so, and then you take your hook, put it going down through all these other bands on the next pin, and then put the other end of this new border band onto your hook as well. Then you would get another border band and start the process all over. So go ahead and do that for all of these bands and all these pins, and you'll just stop when you get to this last pin here with another border band on it. Alright, there we go. So now what we're going to do, once we get to this part here, is we're going to take either one or two border bands, or you can use the same color as you did for your connector bands, which were, mine were clear, so basically a stretchy rubber band, but I'm going to use the same color as my connector band, so I'm going to use two, and you're going to put them both, or you're just going to put it on your hook, however many you're taking. Put them on your hook the same way you did all the other border bands. And just pull the bands up through these other ones here. Then, since there are no other pins to stick your hook going down through, you can just put the other end of the new band onto your hook. And then we're going to make a slip knot. And to do that, we take this loop here, the side of the band that is farthest away from the actual hook part of our hook. We take that band there and we pull it off and over the hook, and also off and over this other loop here, and we don't take that other loop off. We go ahead and tighten the slip knot by pulling on that remaining loop, and then once you think your slip knot is tight enough, you can pull all these other bands off of your loom. And now, you don't need your Alpha Loom for the design anymore, and you also don't need your hook anymore. So, or well, you might need your hook, so just put it to the side. And, well, now, you have your Mega Super Bow, or your Super Mega Bow. Oh gosh, I forgot the name of it already. Okay, well anyway, before we go and, or before I finish the tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and show you a few things you can do with the slip knot here. So one thing you can do is you can take your hook, slide it in through the design some random way. I usually like to stay near the border. Right, stick your hook up through where the slipknot bands are. Kind of get the slipknot bands onto your hook so that you can pull them through, back through the design with your hook. It's usually a little bit difficult because you'll catch other bands when you're doing this. And Sometimes you'll get that. You just flip it to the other side. And then you have your bow charm. And another thing you can do is if you have scissors, which I need to go grab those. There we go. If you have scissors, you can kind of take the slip knot, kind of stretch it out a little bit, just far enough so that you don't end up cutting yourself, because that would be bad. And then you could just cut the bands and, cut the bands here, the loops here, but not too close to the actual design, because then the slip knots will come undone, and then the whole charm will come undone, and that's not good, so. Yes, you can cut them, but I'm not going to cut mine. Well, let's go ahead. So here's what I usually do. Ugh, what am I doing? Okay. Look at the other side. There we go. And then you just have these little bands here. And I honestly prefer taking the bands and just tucking them in through the design. But whichever way you prefer. And yeah, so once you've finished your design off and it's closed off however you want it, then you are now finished your Mecha Super Bow. Or your, yeah, I think that's what it's called. I can't remember. But anyway, now it is time for the outro. So I would like to thank you for watching my tutorial. Hopefully it showed you how to make the Mega Super Bow. Yeah, successfully. Hopefully now you have one. And I'm going to add it to your little charm collection. And this band's a little messed up here. Nope, so is this one. Yeah, I might have to do a little bit of adjusting. The border bands should be on top of all the other bands, like this. But yeah, so that's pretty much all I have to say for this tutorial, actually. So hopefully now you have your little charm, you'll add it to your collection. I will be making another video, another tutorial for how you can kind of extend off of this bow and make like a giant bow headband. And I'll have a link to that tutorial once they make it in the description. It won't be for a little while. But anyway, if you want to check out some other Alpha Loom designs I have, then I'll have a link to my Alpha Loom tutorials playlist and also my Alpha Loom templates playlist, because I do have some bracelet designs and picture designs that you can make with your Alpha Loom. And yeah, so that's pretty much all I have to say for this video, other than thanks for watching, and bye!